Now, in addition to the s orbits, I will slightly discuss the p orbits as well. And here, in the s orbit, we know that L, when L is equal to 0, we are having spherically symmetric orbits, and they are only radial wave function dependent, and there is no dependence on theta and phi. But when we consider any orbit which is not in s orbit, then it will not be spherically symmetric, and the angular dependence will make its shape, which will be not spherically symmetric. So we discussed the 2p orbitals, and when I consider that the L value is non-zero, then we will have the deviation from the spherical symmetry of the orbit of the electron. So let's say for L to be non-zero, the very first value that it can get will be 1. So the L equal to 1, then it means N should be equal to 2 to get L equal to 1, the very first value. So N is equal to 2, and it will cause L equal to 1. So that's why I call this the 2p electron, that L equal to 1 is the p orbital, and 2 comes from the N equals 2. When N is equal to 2 and L is equal to 1, we are having the ML values as 0 and plus minus 1. So now it will have a dependence on both theta and phi. So the theta and phi dependence will be there because ML will also be non-zero as well. So we are having one value ML 0 and the other value ML plus minus 1. So let's start with the ML equal 0. So I will plot the z-axis here, and I will rotate the figures along the z-axis because I will take phi equal to 0, and this is the y-axis, this is the z-axis, and similarly here the minus, and this will be the planar contribution, and for this we will have phi equals 0. So the rotation will be in the y and z plane. This will be the yz plane, and there will be no dependence on the azimuthal angle. We will rotate our orbit like that. So for ML, the first one, ML equals 0. So for ML equal to 0, our distribution, our wave function, and it will be something like this. And on the negative z axis as well. Okay, the two will be exactly symmetric, but my drawing is not that good. So we will have the ML equal to 0 situation like this, and when it will be ML plus minus 1, so we will have, this is the y-axis and this is the z-axis, and we will have the same situation like yz plane and phi equal to 0. So our here means our ML is equal to plus minus 1. For both plus and minus 1, we will have the same distribution, and it will be like this. So this will also be symmetric, exactly a replica on the other side. So this will be for plus minus 1. Let me mark here theta. So if I mark theta here, then it is equal to this. So the angle theta here is this. This is angle theta. And this theta will vary, and it will give a Dumbbell distribution like this. Similarly here, the theta value is this much. So here, when mn is equal to 0, it means that the distribution of the electrons is somewhere like theta equal to 0. Like this. And here this angle is theta equal to 0. Means on the z-axis positive, and most of the electrons, means their probability is found to be on the theta equals pi on the negative z-axis. The electrons are there. When I come here, then the maximum probability here, theta become pi by 2 here, and theta become minus pi by 2 here. So the maximum probability of the electron is in this region, and means this will be the electron distribution picture, that we will have maximum electrons here and here as well. So at theta equal pi by 2 and theta equal minus pi by 2, we will have the electronic distribution. And when I rotate these pictures, when I rotate them, then their probability will be something like this. Let me plot this probability here as well, that when, let me draw first the axes here. So this is our y-axis and this is our z-axis, and here again for mn non-zero, this is z-axis and this is y-axis. Now when our n is equal to 2, our L is equal to 1, and our ML is equal to 0. So this is for ML equal to 0, this situation, and we will have the distribution like this, and here like this. So this is ML equal to 0 situation, and our distribution is somehow like this. Means the electrons are distributed here as well as here. So means they are concentrated on the plus Z and minus Z axes, and we are having this as psi 210. So this will be the probability of our wave function. And as we rotate this along the z-axis, so we will have something like this. And when we will have ML means N2L1 and ML equals plus minus 1, this shape that we get is a Dumbbell shape. This is a Dumbbell shape, and at the center we are having the nucleus, means at the center this is our nucleus, means nucleus of hydrogen atom, and this is the electronic distribution. While when we take the ML plus minus 1, then we will have a donut shape. So a donut shape is like this. It will be hard for me to plot, but I will try. That this is the nucleus, and as we are having nucleus here, and for this one, when I rotate it along the z-axis, I will get a donut shape, and it will be somehow like this, that will go like this. So now let me plot this one. So it is something like the donut shape, and here, although it's very difficult to plot the 3D, but one may consult some images directly available on the internet. So it will be a donut shape like this, and we will have this for our psi 2, 1 and 1, and mod square, this probability is equal to 2, 1 and minus 1 mod square. This probability will be the same for plus minus 1, and as we are having our x-axis here, similarly we will have our x-axis here as well, and this donut shape, we will have our distribution of electrons like this. So combinedly, for n equal to 1, they are sometime plotted like this, means the Dumbbell shape and the donut shape with this, like this. The donut shape is in the middle, so combinedly they can be plotted like this, and individually like this one and this one. So we are having our distribution, means the distribution is then it is around the nucleus, and then it plus and minus z axis. So we have the when theta is equal to pi by 2 and minus pi by 2 on this side, we will have the distribution of the 2p electrons. Remember that we are having in the probability density, the probability density is having no dependence on phi. It is only theta dependent. So our p orbitals are like this, and one may consult the images in 3D in order to get more insight.